Right, tailgate meeting time, guys. Just loading the truck up again, always the unloading and loading trucks and, you know, stuff like that. It's always a pain in the ass. That's my fun part of my day, you know, unloading and loading trucks. That's great. Anyway, hey, you know, I was just chatting with a guy today, and I figured I'd share with you guys, and I don't know, you know, and it's so funny. Over the years, probably, you know, over my most of my lifetime, I'm not as fast as I used to be. Some of you guys say, man, you're a really fast painter, you kick ass. You know, I'm not nearly as fast as I used to be. Some of my guys are faster than me now, but you know, I'm still pretty fast for a guy who's 55, so. But anyway, you know, I get tired quick. It doesn't, you know, I don't run like a full 7-8 hours a day. I can't do it, not like I used to. I used to do 12 hours and, you know, that'd be no problem. Occasionally, I didn't do that very much, but usually I can get, if I can't get it done in 6 or 7 hours, usually, you know, I need to go back to painting school. So the way I figure is somebody said today, you know, this was, I'm just going to comment on this, just thought it would be interesting. See what you guys say. He says he can do Eaves faster than me. Now, he can do his Eaves faster than me. I usually go through and I'll spray all my Eaves. You watch my Eave video, I've gone through. I spray the eaves and I go back with the brush and I just bring the wall up into the eave with a brush. And when I was working by myself, I'd do the fascia board and the under edge at the same time. And then I'd touch up my stucco. And then when I was done with that wall, the whole wall's done. I didn't need to go back. There's all the touch-ups are done. Everything's done on one side of the house. So I'll give you an example. Let me see. So like, I would spray my eaves, and then when I have stucco wall, I go through here and I would, this one here, I'd do the shield, and then I just come back and do a little bit of touch up. But I would go ahead and spray the under the eaves and get paint on the stucco, and then I just go back and touch it up with a brush versus going through and masking all these off and then spraying it. Because typically, most people, when they mask, they have to go up with their masking people. Usually a lot of times you have a masking crew and they go through. Some of my guys do this, okay, so it's all right. I let them do whatever they want to do if they want to do it that way. But they mask off all the eaves ahead of them. And one guy goes up and masks all the eaves, and the other person goes over, sprays it, and then you go to pull off all the paper. Most of the time you can get it off in one shot, right? You start to pull it and sometimes it goes, but what happens, you know, sometimes is it gets stuck somewhere and it doesn't come off. Usually you have to have some, you know, you have to climb a ladder a couple times to get down the masking. Well, this guy says his way is faster than mine because I can go up in two processes. So I'll go up, I spray my stucco, right? Spray the eaves. I go up with a brush to do the fascia board. When I was working by myself, I bring a brush, do my fascia board, and I would bring up another brush with me at the same time. So I'd go up twice, okay? I'd go up and do the spray the eaves, go back up the second time, do the fascia, and then in the under edge. And I found that, you know, carrying two buckets is about the most I want to carry up a ladder. So this isn't the first time I've heard this. You know, a guy says, yeah, man, my way's faster, I'll be in the truck before you are. And every single time over all the years that I've been working, I have never had a guy beat me, never. And so, you know, I'm not saying that, you know, there isn't a possibility somebody could be faster than me. But, you know, and especially at my age now, I probably would be beaten by somebody even if they were masking it off and pulling it off, because I'm just not as fast as I used to be. Maybe for a couple hours I could be, but I'm pretty old. You know, when you're in your 50s, you know, bring it on. You know, if you're 55 and you think you can beat my ass, you know, bring it on. Okay, it probably won't happen. But anyway, most guys at 50s aren't painting anymore. You know, I don't have to paint. I don't even have to work. I don't have to do anything. I can retire right now if I wanted to. I just do it. I mean, look, let me just put it this way. What do you make a day? You make $200, $300, $400, maybe you make $500 in a day, and you're like, wow, I make $500 a day. Add a zero to that, okay? And then decide that you're going to turn down work. that's kind of where I'm at, guys. So, you know, I turned it down a lot, but man, when you get those kind of numbers, it's like, fuck it. You know, I mean, I got to go out and work. Why not? You know, so, but not always. There's some jobs I do just because they're repeat customers and they can't find somebody else to do their house. Like the house I was just doing, very high net worth people, been doing it for 14 years. And, you know, I'm just not going to find somebody else who can do, you know, what they want done, you know, and, you know, and make it the way they want it and touch it up and make it look right. And they'd be trying to sell them a new paint job when there's no reason to. The paint's still in good shape. So anyway, let's talk about this for real quick, what this guy says. He says he carries up a deuce, two-gallon bucket with the stucco, with the trim paint, okay, a brush, probably a mini roller in there, okay. He brings that up. He brings a hand masker up with him. He carries a roll of tape on his wrist like this. I can't do this because my hands are too big. But he puts a roll of tape on his wrist. See, I can't even get it in there. My hands are too big. So you guys are fortunate who can do that. Has a roll of tape on his wrist. He has a spray gun. And what else? And all this stuff. And his paper masker. And so you need a paper masker and a roll of tape at the same time when you're going up to do this with masking. And he goes up and he masks. And then he sprays that area. And then he does the fascia board in that same section. And then he moves up the ladder and he does the same thing again. You know, honestly, if it was me and I had to carry all this equipment up with me all at the same time, if I was carrying up a brush and I got a spray gun and I got, you know, all that stuff up with me, all that stuff would slow me down so much that I would be slower than if I just went up and did it the way I normally do it. So, you know, because I've already done stuff like this. I've done basically, you know, guys think that I haven't tried this stuff, you know, other than I can't put a roll of tape in my wrist. But, you know, he says that would be faster. He'd be in the truck ahead of me. And, you know, honestly, I doubt it. I really doubt it. But, and it's funny because I've had guys do that. I've had so many guys over the years, they tell me, oh man, I got a better way. I'm faster than you and I can beat you. And I'm like, all right, that's cool. So you start over here and do yours and I'll start over here and do mine. And I'll meet you in the middle. And usually I'm like almost twice as far as they are by the end of the day. So anyway, just thought I'd throw that out there. But I don't know. Tell me what you guys think. I want to see if you guys think it's possible. I mean, maybe it is. Okay. Carry a bucket, a brush, or mini roller to do the fascia, a roll of tape on your wrist, a hand masker in your back pocket, and a spray gun all up at the same time going up the ladder, up an extension ladder, to do your eave gables. And do you think that's gonna be able to be done in one trip and be fast? Just thought I'd just throw that out there, see what you guys think. All right, so that's it just for the tailgate meeting today. I'll talk to you guys in the next video. Please like, share, and subscribe.